Hey guys, so today I have a Bantu knot out. I did Bantu knots and I honestly like them better in than out, but these are the curls. Yeah, I think it'll do. I used Uncle Funky Starter products for this hairstyle. I used the Midnight Train Leave-In Conditioner, Extra Butter Curl Forming Cream. I don't believe I used anything else. I used oil. But aside from that, that's it. This is a good one day type style. Like, let's see here. Yeah, I like it. I think it's cute. Color looks good. Yeah. Will I do this style again? I don't know. I didn't have any problems sleeping with these because I parted my hair down the center in the back so that I wouldn't have any Bantu knots right where I lay my head at night. So I slept fine and they weren't too tight. The only thing that I would do differently is probably sit under the dryer just for this side, and more so that the heat could set my hair, because there's something about this side of my hair, it just does not work without gel. So other than that, I think it came out nicely. So guys, if you love this video, please thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. It's been a long time since I've been on here, but I'm happy to be able to share this style with you guys. All right, guys. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Starting off on semi-clean hair that's been in a bun for a week, I'm going to spray each section with the Midnight Train Leave-In Conditioner, and then I'm going to add some moisture with the Extra Butter Curl Forming Cream. I'm using a little bit of each of these products because I don't want my hair to be really wet. I want it to be mostly dry so that it won't take long for my Bantu knots to dry. So I comb out each section and then I twist it up and put it away. I also don't want my hair to be too moist because I've learned that Bantu knots come out best with dry hair. I'm going over each section with a little bit of castor oil just to seal in the moisture. From there, I'm just parting my hair into sections. These sections are kind of big because I want loose waves. I brush out each section, which is very important to get smoothness. And then I start twisting. So I'm twisting down the strand and then I'm going to wrap and then twist a little bit more and then wrap a little bit more. And when you're wrapping, pay close attention. I'm wrapping the hair close to the base, nearest to the scalp, and around until I'm finished. And once I get to the tip of the hair, I'm just going to add a little bit more of the butter and then wrap the ends very tightly around the base. I decided not to use rubber bands or bobby pins to seal my ends, so I made sure the ends were tucked tightly. I'll show you guys one more time how I do this. I'm just twisting my hair and then wrapping near the base. And I twist again and then wrap again near the base. I make sure that I start at the end of my hair when I'm twisting, because if you start too high up, then these knots will be way tight and it'll hurt your head. So I'm combing out the tips and then I'm going to repeat this all over my head in big sections. Alright, so it's the next day and I'm taking these babies down. So what I'm going to do is use olive oil a little bit on my hands just to make sure that I don't create any unnecessary frizz. And when I take down the knots, I'm going to untwist them in the opposite direction in which I twisted them initially. Okay, to separate the curls, I'm kind of just gently letting my hair separate wherever it separates naturally, if that makes sense. It's just like taking down curls for any other style. You want to have a little bit of oil on your hands so that you won't get too much frizz, and then just kind of let it naturally separate. I couldn't find my pick, so I ended up using a wide tooth comb to kind of fluff out my hair a little bit to give it some more volume. So instead of leaving the style out, I'm just going to pin a little bit of my hair up on the side just to give it a little sass. And that's it, guys. I hope you liked this tutorial. Thanks for watching.